The person in the video sitting is Peter Powell, one of the former BBC's top entertainers and hosts for pop programmes. And he had his own radio show, The Peter Powell Show, on BBC for many, many years. And he's introducing today's guests, Dead or Alive, That's the Way I Like It. Now, I was inspired to do this reaction because I've been watching Eurovision. I've reacted to the controversies it's attached to this particular video that went on before, during, and now after, allegedly, to do with different acts. So do watch out for that. Now, when it came to Dead or Alive, Netta, a former winner of Eurovision, flew through the air and sang a Pete Burns song from Dead or Alive called You Spin Me Round and Round and Round. Not since Jimmy Kimmel did his mem version of Pete Burns spinning around have I been so entertained. Netta, you slayed it. You really did. You were the moment in Eurovision I went, wow, this girl has blossomed. Now, when it came to honouring spinning around and around, has it been saturated? Well, I was persuaded by Pete Burns himself and an interview he did with Davina McCall on YouTube. I watched it. He was evicted from Big Brother, and she was the host for many, many seasons in England to do with Big Brother. And she would introduce all the celebrities when there was a celebrity one and the other seasons when there was just normal people in it. Now, Davina McCall asked him a question, and it was to do with a certain song. What song was it? You Spin Me Round and Around. And Pete just went, ugh. And he reacted in a negative way and said he was fed up with it. He was fed up with talking about it, doing remixes about it. He was just fed up. He had a catalogue of music that was being ignored. I thought about that now after watching that. So I'd seen Netta's. I thought about doing Spinning Around. I seen Jimmy Kimmel and I thought about doing Spinning Around. Then I saw the interview and realized, in honor of a man that was fed up with his own song, I'm going to do That's the Way I Like It, because Pete sang this live version of a KC and the Sunshine Band, because it wasn't Pete's song. It was a cover song he did, and he came on with only Pete Burns could do, in a gritty way, but also delicate way. He sang this song live, and it's the best live version. And I just thought, you know what, spinning around, you go that way. And welcome to this particular song. Very short lyrics, by the way, as well. When it came to the bio of the song, I was very intrigued, because I've just mentioned whom sang it, and I only knew that from my research, and they were the American disco and funk band, KC and Sunshine Band. The single came from the band's number one hit, the Billboard 100, hit the Billboard 100 at number one, and is one of the few chart toppers in history to hit the number one position in America on more than one occasion. Now, that happened because of this reason, and it happened in 1975. It topped the chart for 1 week, then it was replaced by Fly Robin Fly by Silver Connection. That's the Way I Like It returned to number one for more than 1 week after Fly Robin Fly completed 3 weeks at number one. That's the Way I Like It also spent a further week at number one. So that's what happened. It made history. It was an international chart in many countries: Canada, Netherlands, Belgium, New Zealand, Norway, United Kingdom, West Germany, and Australia, featuring either in the top 20 or in the top 10 or in the top 5. Now, for a release as a single and radio airplay, the song was toned down from the original recording, which would have jeopardized it receiving getting any airplay, which I didn't know at the time. However, the sexual overtures may have been improved by the record's reception at discos, because it increased its popularity in the charts. Now, fast forward to Pete Burns. Pete Burns and Dead or Alive came out with That's the Way I Like It, the best of Dead or Alive, a combination album of different songs, track listing 1 to 18 on the album, I believe. And it had My Heart Goes Bang, Lover Come Back to Me, and of course, this particular single, That's the Way I Like It. And it was the third greatest hits album by Dead or Alive. Now, and it was also the last release because Pete Burns died in 2016. A box set 5 days after his death came out, Sophisticated Boombox. So that's the whole history behind this particular song. We have the lyrics, which are short and sweet, and I'm looking forward to listening and reminding myself of why I called it on my thumbnail the best live version of it, and proved that Pete Burns was a formidable singer.
Their single is in the shops on Monday. It's called That's the Way I Like It. This is Dead or Alive.
Keep that body strong.
there's the smiling Pete Burns after performing that. And as you've seen, the crowd were actually mesmerized. People said they were very non-responsive, but they were in shock because unlike a lot of mind artists that came on to that particular program, Pete came on and sang live. Did Casey and the Sunshine Band love that song? Members of the band said they were floored by it. I'm not surprised. It was a great cover version in honor of a band that made history in America. So it really married very, very well and proved to all the people that thought Pete Burns was all hair and he didn't care because he had a very, as you would see in the prior to his eviction in the Big Brother, he's had a very, very sharp way of saying things. He was very black or white. And he even said after his eviction, didn't surprise him that he was evicted because people can't handle his very strong personality. He's just very, he doesn't say anything to please you. That's the way it is. And that's the way he liked it. And as Davina said, did he regret anything? No. Now, in honor of this man, I put love hearts. Thank you for the memories. I've a little tidbit to give you. I went to a very rebellious headmaster I had in a school that was very anti-English. And me and my siblings came from England to Ireland, Irish parents, Irish relatives, to a village full of relatives. You can't imagine how many cousins were in my school. Nearly everybody was, hello, hello, cousin. But anyway, the headmaster was, how can I put this, intolerant of blow-ins. That's what we were termed as coming from England. So when it came to my ball dance at the end of the year, I got a very good friend called Rosita to do my hair. And it went all the way up and all the way across. And who did I replicate? Because Pete was in many different little bands before Dead or Alive became the big thing. And I was inspired by the hair. And I went onto the bus with the dark makeup and the hair at the time. And I just floored everybody. They said, you're going like that. I remember wearing my mother's gloves and stretching them. Thank God they were stretchable leather. Because I really, as you can tell, very big hands. And I put them on and I went on the school bus and everybody just went, oh, you can't go like that. Oh my God, he's gay. I didn't know he was homosexual. So all those bad words at the time were floating around behind me and everybody who knew me well was laughing, going and clapping, fair play to you. And I went, and it wasn't any of his hits, not even this I was singing at the time. Some punkish type song. I'm still looking for it. I can't remember the title, and there's nothing worse than not knowing really the chorus, but you have the images in your head. I'll get there and I'll react to it. In honor again of Pete. But I went on the bus, went to the ball, and my headmaster was just, how dare you turn up like this and humiliate the school? And because there was a national photographer taking pictures. I wasn't in any of the papers. My parents were blessed. And pity, because if I showed those pictures now, people would say I was cool. At the time, I was rebellious, I was demonic, I was everything that you can imagine. And yes, I did pass my exams at the end of the year, and I went on to become what I am today, a musical reactor. So a little bit of a nice little fun story. Because when it comes to the lyrics, it's only going to take 2 minutes of the lyrics, because I basically have to go back to the original video of this. And just go, that's the way I like it. I'm just going to repeat a few of the lines. I like it. When you give me all your love and you do it the best you can. Ooh, that's the way I like it. I think we can get the vibes of these lyrics already. And then it repeats it. That's the way. So when you're intimate, what sounds do you make and do you like it? This is why they had to tone down the overtures in the disco if that had been out at the time of my bull, Dead or Alive were very prominent as they were at my bull around the 80s, start of the 80s, I would have so been rebellious with that song. The things I would have done on the dance floor. I'd have made out with a mop. I wouldn't have cared. And so when you whisper sweet in my ear, when you turn me on, that's the way I like it. So they're the repeated lines of the song. It's a very over-sexualized song for intimacy. And that's what it was about. But he performed it in such a delicate, wonderful way that only the late P. Burns could have done. Whether you're dead, whether you're alive, Pete, today it makes no difference because you'll always be iconic. May you always rest in peace, and thank you for the music. Thanks for listening, everybody. Don't forget to comment on your best Dead or Alive song that you've danced to or reacted to. Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.